Hello YouTube, Stevo Truck here. Surely by now you've probably heard my sort of official announcement, but this is going to be my proper announcement video for those who sort of skipped over my vlog. And you probably sussed it out with the hashtags as well, so no dramas. And basically it's announced I'm going to Truckfest at Shipton Mallet, or Truckfest Southwest, which I believe end of August to September. I'll confirm the dates and I'll post it up above or in the comments down below. Something like the 30th to the 1st weekend that falls around then. Go on the Truckfest website and you'll find the actual information out either way, and of all the other shows as well. By the way, I'm not sponsored by Truckfest. This is all on my back and my company's support, and that's it. Just for legal purposes, so no one goes around accusing me of getting sponsored or anything of that nature, no. So, as I said, it's something I've always wanted to go and do. I'll be taking, obviously, my truck and my trailer. But the good news is, it's going to probably start a new series as well to follow me on the road to Truckfest. And the thing is, it's a series, even after this Truckfest, if I enjoy it, I'll add to that series in the future. So if I go to another truck show, say, next year, even if it's the same one, you follow the build-up towards it again. You know, I might improve how I do the prep, you know. Certainly going first time there, I'm bound to learn new stuff and go, actually, that might be a better way of doing things. So I've got stuff to invest into as well. So I've got to buy myself I'm looking at getting one of those fold out step ladders so I can get to the top of the truck. Yeah, so we've got stuff like that to look forward to. You know, as I said, it's going to build onto my videos. Also, this is sort of a sort of a channel update video as well, you'd probably say as well. I'm feeling that the analytics are going the right way. I realise I made some errors in how the channel was set up. My bad, and thank you very much to, I keep forgetting your name, who's posted twice now about the matter. It was public, but I realised I had, you know, YouTube had changed all the settings in there, and that I think hides videos. I think it's viewable if you got my channel, but it hides like my like videos and stuff like that, and what I'm subscribed to and all sorts, or commented on. So that may have been an issue. The primary one was unchecked, which was good, because that's what I watched a tutorial video the other day on it, which was very helpful, just to make sure, because I was, you know, I've been having second thoughts about, you know, the traffic to the channel. It's been okay, it's been on a steady increase over the last week or so, but for the steady increase, it doesn't seem to be climbing. It's steadily increasing, but very steadily, if that makes any sense. But I'm also very impressed that the subscriber count has gone up as well, you know, that, and also what's the YouTuber's name? Everything's going out of my head at the moment. I think it's Scott Andrews, the Welsh tuber on the Road Legends. Sometimes I go a little bit far across and accidentally get it into the crawl. I found out what I've been doing wrong with the gearbox as well. So I'm a bit more wary on that front. So it's stuff you learn all the time. Yeah, Yeah, Scott Andrews had subscribed the other weekend, which I didn't expect at all. And another YouTuber as well, I've gotten your name, I've only recently subscribed to you, and I've only just found you. Well, that's mainly through Scott Andrews. Liked the videos, I was just going through his, or subscribed to things to see who else is out there. Which, it's always nice to see. I said I commented on one of his videos to say that it's always nice to find another new, or not new, he's been going for a few years by the looks of it, but it's always nice to find another vlogger in the trucking hemisphere. I'll try and link the videos down below, or the links to the channels down below. If not, check out my my subscribe channels. I've sorted out my subscribe things. You know, I do actually have two accounts. I have a personal account, but sometimes I just watch stuff on my YouTube account as well. So, and to do it, it's tidying up to realise that I had some like my gaming stuff on my liked videos and on the channel. So I thought, no disrespect to those other channels, it's just I want to keep this, obviously, channel, obviously, all professional as much as possible, and anything it's connected into it is all related to the subject or subject matter, either way. That's the general gist, not do anything funny, it's just saying keep it tidier, you know, more current to what I'm doing. Yeah, so I feel like everything's going well. There's always improvements. I'm constantly working on the channel. You know, I'm just tinkering here and there. Well, you could have gone instead of stopping in an awkward spot. Never mind. Take it steady here, because people like to fly around this corner. I know you can't see forward, but hopefully you like this angle, or hopefully, you know, it's a good angle to you. I haven't vlogged yesterday, but I was not really in the mood. I might do a bit more filming today when I fully wake up. I might do a new truck tour video as well today, depending on the weather and where I find myself. Might be at the same place where I did it last time. I can see it happening. I can't really do it on customer sites. I could do it, but it'd be a struggle, so I have to make sure I do not film the customer site. It should be awkward. As you may see, I've got a new backing to the cab as well. I've temporarily fixed it up. Hopefully it holds as it is, but my main issue is the light board. As far as I'm aware, I need to re-clarify with the boss. I'm not allowed to screw into the backboard. What I've done, I've used some double-sided Velcro tape. Well, not double-sided, but Velcro tape, but used both parts of it and stuck it on the back. I tried it with the, you know, the bit that bites in onto material, but it doesn't quite bond with, no matter what I do. It slightly bonds, but not strong enough to hold it on. But I found if I use both sides and use a sticky bit, it seems to hold. But you know, if you have any suggestions for securing light boards, I'm all ears. I have also put two pins at the top just as like a safety measure. Even though they won't fully hold, it'll delay it from. But so far it's done pretty well. It's only sort of come off once, and since then it's, touch wood, it's pretty solid. My main concern is when we get to summer, change of temperatures, if it's anything like last year, but we can only see. Time will tell. You never know, it might just hold perfectly, but I'm always a bit sceptical when you hold things on with tape. Because I had a duck thing on the dash and that came off over time. Probably because I didn't stick it on properly, that's probably the reason why. you know, I didn't clean the surface accurately. Lasted for a while though. I could always re-stick it back up, but I have got some more double-sided tape as well. Yeah, so we've got a new truck tour video to come, which is obviously going to be a remake, because I've added a few other things into the cab. The only thing I'm missing, which I was hoping to have this week, which might stop me from filming it this week, because hopefully by next week I will have it, is I will have some window decals to put on. That hopefully, if I've ordered the right ones, should meet the same sort of colour as that's on my outside of the truck, which looks slightly different in a way, but fairly typical, that's what I'll say. And as you may see, I've got the curtains and the cab. What are we filming on? 1080p. That's good. So what I may do, I've also got myself a laptop as well. Not a real powerful one. It's reasonable, but it's not uber powerful. But it'll do the job, so I can do a little bit of video editing during the week, or at least move the files off the camera per day and sort them out on my external hard drive I've got with me. So when I get home, it reduces the amount of time spent editing the video, because it will be sort of, hopefully, in theory, as I label it up correctly, pretty easy. Just go, yep, I want those videos for this one, that's the intro or the announcement video, whatever it'll be, you know. So I thought I'll announce I'm going to Truckfest and ship to Mallet this year, on to reiterate, which I am, as you probably gathered if you watched my the vlog from this week. Very excited about, obviously, so I am concentrating on the road as well. So I'm going to be hyped up about that for until I do it, probably. But as I said, hopefully, I'm thinking about doing a new series tied in with it, which I think could be a little bit different, because you always see vloggers going to truck shows and all that, but you don't really see much of the build-up. You don't see the cleaning that goes in, you don't see... And it's, you know, something I've always been curious about, going, well, what have you done to your truck? Because you always see them announce they're going to go, then you might see something, and then you see them at the truck show, and you're like, okay. What did you do to get there? I'm not going to ask, I don't know, if you want to see how you order the tickets, I could do, obviously I'm not going to buy another set. I've already, I said, booked already, so all booked in. My brother should be coming as well, which is a pro. I'm going to have a word with a couple of companies that I've worked for in the past, locally to where I live, to ask if I could use the wash facility, see which one gives me the better deal, which I expect either to pay or, say, pass a crate of beer over or so, or lick a bit of both. We'll see. I've got an idea who I want to get in touch with, but I'm not going to announce it yet, because I want to ask them permission if they're happy for me to announce who I'm using to promote them a wee bit. Yeah, so we've got plans in circulation. You know, this will be about a 20-minute video, I reckon. But yet again, I'm very impressed with the recent subs. Subs have been going up for me quite a bit. I've had 10 subs this week. I've lost, I think, one or two, which I have no idea what was going on there. I've had my first dislike this week, which is bound to happen. I was expecting that to happen. I was actually quite surprised it didn't happen already. I was a bit shocked, actually. But nevertheless, it's all very positive. And to be honest, even the dislike is a support to the channel, but I'm a bit... My only criticism to dislikes is if you're going to dislike, add a comment if it is something that you really don't like. You know, so actually, I'm not too keen. You know, if it's part of, you know, not all my video series will be for everybody. You know, so like some of the training and education videos that I'm doing, or services videos, you know, some people might not be bothered about that or overly interested. But if there is something you don't like, you know, or something that could be altered, comment, you know, so that actually, could you do this instead? Or some of it will take time to implement, so I know I need to work on a few things. Bad, not compared to the other day when you had that other SUV. You had a car driver there who almost tried to go head on with me down the single track. Yes, look amiss. You know, I'm in kind of a big truck. It's not like you couldn't have seen me.
After 300 yards, turn left.
Makes you wonder these days what. Yeah, I know a lot of car drivers aren't observant. Ahead of them further than, you know, by less than 100 metres, maybe 50 if you're lucky. That's as far as observance may go. If you're lucky with some car drivers. And it really does make you wonder what goes through people's heads. Good to go, we're good to go. Yeah, so, as I said, it's all very positive. It's very much like the update I had last week. It's almost going to be like a weekly update at the moment. But as I said, you know, unless there's some big news or something, you know, burning that I need to announce, which it could become a weekly update on occasions, especially if I've got, you know, someone to be as open and clear about how I think the channel's going. Because at the moment I'm feeling very motivated. There seems to be a lot of support of what I've seen. It could have been better. Some of it was my setup on the fairly on the channel originally setting up. You know, I've done a lot of work over the last few weeks or over the last month or so on the channel. Now I've turned it right around, I feel. And as I said last week, you know, I think I'm starting to see roots of labour, as they would say. But as I said, if you have any ideas for videos or anything that you would like to see sooner, or you know, I do have stuff in the pipeline. You know, as I said, a lot of it lays on certainly the stuff outside the truck depends on where I'm at, if I have time. That's a lot more, a lot lays on is if I've free time to do it. You know, I would love to do the truck tour in somewhere quite scenic, which I do find myself quite a bit in, but to find the right area to do it is the trick. And obviously not interfering in work. As I said, the laptop is a great aid. That should be a good multiplier in terms of even getting some videos out in the week, or in my working week, shall I say. So I might try and edit this tonight and see about uploading. We'll see what time we finish today, how I feel, how knackered I feel. It should be a hard video to do. You know, it should be relatively, you know, it's going to be a 20-minute video, which probably will take my system I've got with me, because it's 1080p, probably about 2 hours maybe it took on my test run the other day. Maybe less, because I'm not putting as much demand on it this time, hopefully. Because that was your pressure test I done the other day on it. But it seems to edit videos pretty well. I don't expect it to do 4K though, so don't expect any of my 4K releases to be done in the week. Even though I am aiming to go to full 2.5K 4K. Not true 4K all the time, because space on the cameras, but I do mix on my 4K videos. There is actual 4K in there, mainly off my GoPro because it's so efficient at it.
Ahead, keep left.
I won't film this in 4K, but I thought actually I'll keep it in 1080. I only just realised what I want, so I had to play around with. That's the other thing I was looking at yesterday while I was playing with. If you notice on my channel, which I've deleted those videos off already, I was testing live streaming on it, which it works, it looks reasonably good. I was just sorting out a format how to do it. Phone worked out better, but the problem with the phone is standing it up somewhere and that sort of jobby. With the camera it's easy enough, but it wasn't very easy to know if you were actually recording.
Turn left.
Or, you know, to see the chat. I need to work on that a wee bit. Because I would like to be a bit more interactive during my working week, if you know what I mean. Then I feel, you know, that would aid into improving the channel, getting content that you would want out, you know, and also content I would like out as well, and improving both forms of content, which, you know, that's one of my main goals, is to keep on improving, keep on upping the quality, reducing me muttering on. I know this is a long video because I'm on and on, but it's just a iterate certain things about the channel, how I feel it's going, you know, the direction I want to aim it in, the very rough plan of the channel. I mean, I've got several playlists. There is one I'm thinking about sort of merging into the other because it's sort of redundant in a way, and maybe renaming that complete, because it's more of a chat videos really, that really I think they can just be merged into one. Services are still going ahead, that's all okay. I said I have not had any chance, you know, to film any new services as of yet. So I do apologise if that seemed to be on a bit of a hold at the moment. There's going to be more training videos coming up, vlogs, there'll be probably one vlog a week. Because I have noticed it isn't my most popular series, but it's a series I want to do. That's sort of like my hobby bit, and that will improve over time, and you never know, that might pick up, it might not, you know, we'll see. The most popular playlist tends, what I've noticed, is obviously the training videos. The services was okay, and that had some interest. That's what I'm saying, there is videos coming to that, but services, I need to have time, be in the mood at the services to do it, and to know a bit about the services that I'm at to do it, to make a fair judgement on the site. Yeah, so there's a lot in the pipeline, there's a lot in the works to come, stuff to look forward to, like Truckfest, you know, another truck tour, the build-up series to the Truckfest. But don't cut the corner, Mr. White Van Man. You don't have to do that. You literally cut right in front of me on my side. Almost side scraping me. I'm like, what are you doing? You had loads of room to the right to turn in on this side. I think some people think they're driving an Arctic. Everybody seems in a rush today on Saturday, but never mind. Because I've had about four drivers on the way in who decide, well, that wasn't so bad, that guy, but that's typical for there. People get impatient after that junction. But I can see an accident happening. Sorry, I've still got a lick of it at the tail end of that cold still. It's improving, but slowly. Yeah, so, yeah, I had four cars this morning who, well, two had overtook me on double solid white lines with oncoming traffic. One with oncoming traffic on the double white lines, one that, yeah, fair enough, both sequences, they shouldn't have overtaken no matter what anyway. But yeah. And the other two, more head-oners, as I call them. You know, going, right, we'll get past you even if it's suicidal. You know, causing me having to slow down, one quite dramatically slow down, almost emergency. But it is what it is. Oh, that's a cow. I was wondering what that was, wheezy over that. It looked like an alien at first. I was like, what is that? Oh, there's a cow. Yeah. Yeah, so I've had a few Muppets today already, which is a bit surprising early hours on a Saturday morning. Normally it's not that busy that people are that much in a rush. No, above my head, totally. I've started actually listening to some audiobooks on almost Trucker J's advice, which I did do a long time ago, and actually I've been quite enjoying it so far. So, audiobooks I like to listen to is like naval, like 18th century naval audiobooks I really enjoy, you know, because I find it fascinating in a way. I know it's a hard time in that sort of period of time, but it's fascinating listening to books of that sort of era. Oh, I've put some works here now. Ah, those are just a beer, they weren't here this morning. Yeah, so what I'll do, I will catch you
turn right
in my next video. I'm going to make it through these road works before I do the full outro. So my concentration is fully on what I need to be doing. Well, the fastest I've gone out of that junction. Thanks to the lights being in my favour. Yeah, so thank you very much for watching. It is appreciated. As I said, any comments on the channel, advice is always welcome, you know. And seriously, I do when I do apologise about the chap who's commented on my last update video and on my last vlog video as well about the similar sort of same thing. You know, a bit like then, I do actually look into what the advice is, see if it would change and improve the channel. And yes, I've looked at it. I've also redone the tagging of the channel again this week. I've introduced hashtagging on the channel, as you may have noticed. So how the hashtags quickly and how the hashtags go work on the channel, they'll be fairly relevant to the video they're on, unless if there's a big announcement like Truckfest, that might be in a few videos around it, and every so often after, just to sort of reiterate it. But in general, they'll be more or less related to the channel and the video they're on. So say if it's about a services, I will try and do a hashtag maybe for that services name. You know, for example. So nevertheless, and also on say, as I always say in almost every single video, thank you very much to all those who have subscribed. It is very much seriously appreciated. I'm focusing on the way, by the way. I'm trying to look at you, but also focus on what I'm doing. And also, yet again, to all those who have commented and watched the channel. You know, it all motivates me to improve the content, to put more content out, to, you know, be a bit more interactive, if possible, you know, to push myself. You know, and this is one reason why I do YouTubing, is to gain some more skills, to learn new things, to become more confident at being in front of a camera and being more confident in general, and maybe not social, but you know, to improve on communication, enunciation, hopefully, a little bit. I do try and honestly work on it. I know I can speed up now and again, and I do apologise. I apologise all the time, don't I? I need to sort that one out. But yes, yeah, so thank you very much for watching yet again. You know, as I keep on saying, it is seriously very much appreciated. And yeah, I'll catch you in the next one. Over and out.